and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess before Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I Salvation, who seeking to
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jacob was the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom Jesus was born, who is called Christ. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. Having her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to send her away quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. For he will save his people from their sins. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. The Gospel of the Lord. When we see a Broadway play, it is customary to have the actors appear on the stage at its conclusion to receive the applause of the audience. The people who are often not acknowledged are those who have worked behind the scenes, helping it all to happen. St. Joseph is one of those people who worked behind the scenes of our redemption. In reflecting on the nativity of Jesus, a special place has quite properly been given to Mary. After her, often come the Magi, the shepherds, the angelic choir, Herod, even the ox and the ass. Only recently in the life of the Church has St. Joseph been brought forward. His place backstage in the work of our redemption speaks some crucial truths to us about the potential of his intercession for us. At a time when Mary and Jesus were very vulnerable, Joseph brought strength and unity to the Holy Family. As patron of the Universal Church, he can help us realize that we are one family as a church. We do not have to be torn by factions, strife, and interest groups. The Church needs liberals and conservatives, young and old, those who look back and those who look forward. It may be that the Church in every age faces dangers from enemies outside, and against these we seek the intercession of St. Joseph. There is also a more subtle enemy within the Church that would divide the family of Jesus Christ into warring subdivisions, suspicious of every word uttered by other people, seeking the conquest and demolition of those who think differently. We are a big family within the unity of faith. St. Joseph, as patron of the Universal Church, can and give us the strength and unity of the Holy Family that is so powerfully preserved through all kinds of dangers. Saint Joseph is also the patron saint of fathers. Being a father or mother at any time is a challenge. Today, children are exposed to influences from many sources from which parents cannot thoroughly protect them. Fathers and mothers all need grace and trust in God. Saint Joseph trusted the word of the angel in today's Gospel reading. Through that trust, he became an agent in the fulfillment of the ancient promises the letter to the Romans describes. Parents cannot forever insulate their children from the perils of the internet, the media, television, and the attitudes of people their children will encounter in their lives. Parents, however, can give their children the equipment and the criteria by which to judge what is spiritually healthy and what is not. Part of raising a child is to teach him or her how to avoid dangers from hazardous things, spoiled food, and harmful materials. Parents can provide their children with enormous help in living life if they are able to point out what is dangerous about certain reading materials, harmful friendships, and television programs that sour lifestyles much more than they do commercial products. The intercession of Saint Joseph can enable adults not only to be biological parents, but spiritual fathers and mothers as well. They can be vehicles for God's plan, as surely as Saint Joseph was. Finally, Saint Joseph has been called the patron saint of a happy or a peaceful death. Christian devotion has pictured Jesus at his side during those last hours. We can just imagine Jesus and Mary next to Joseph when he was dying. Our prayer to Saint Joseph can be that we will know a peaceful passage when our moment of death comes. That peace flows from our knowing that we have done our best to do the work of Lord has given to us, that we have been faithful to our responsibilities and have been cooperative instruments of the Lord. In a time of fewer priests, we can no longer be assured that we will have a priest at our side when our life here is ending. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we can pray that Christ will be with us as our work here on earth comes to a close, ready to be another faithful servant to be with him forever. It is a gift of God's grace that Saint Joseph has come out from backstage at this period of the Church's life with his powerful intercession. He can help us realize that as a church, we are a diverse and large family, but still a family. He can help parents in the difficult work of preparing their children to live in a world that is adrift in so many ways by giving them an awareness of their ultimate destination and the moral judgment to help them. Finally, Saint Joseph can help us appreciate that a peaceful death Joseph was important in Jesus' earthly life. He is important in ours today as well.
We pray for ourselves that we may know the guidance of God in all
simple home of Nazareth. May our minds be always open to your way, and our hearts ready to follow Jesus, your Son and our Lord. Amen.
Of the earth. Thank you.
peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faithful church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, the living and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Number 257.
your centers.